Moin.
Hi and welcome to Watch and Work. Watch and Work is ContiTech's service video series for automotive mechanics. In them you'll learn how to change timing belts on a wide range of vehicle engines. Simply, safely and quickly. The videos show the key working steps for workshop pros. They might take a few minutes, but it's worth staying with them. You'll more than make up this time later on when fitting the belt and any other necessary components. My name is Stefan Meyer, and in each video I'll show you a different vehicle engine. So let's take a look now at today's subject. Today I've got a 2005 Ford Focus for you. We have here a 1.6-liter 66-kilowatt TDCi engine with engine code HHDA. For this we need our CT1092 WP1 water pump kit, plus our VD1094 torsional vibration damper and MS08 fitting kit. Toolbox VO4 contains the special tools required. Before you can set the engine to TDC, you must first remove the upper and lower timing belt guards. To do so, start by removing the vibration damper and then screwing the bolt back in so that you can turn the engine over. You need to focus on three marks when setting TDC. First, there's a bore at the bottom of the crankshaft into which you insert a pin. Then the fuel pump at about 5 o'clock and finally at the top at the camshaft sprocket. Before you can release the tension in the timing belt to remove it, you first have to remove the sensor and the guide for the belt. Next, you have to loosen the tensioning pulley nut, after which you can remove the timing belt. Another important point to note, only use the supplied seal with the water pump. Do not use any additional sealing compound paste. The sealing compound paste can be detached, become lodged in the water pump or block the cooling circuit. In addition, only use new coolant and flush the cooling circuit. Now you can change the components. In addition, please check the remaining sprockets for damage. When fitting the new tensioning pulley, please make sure that the U here encloses this cam. Fit the new timing belt clockwise, starting at the crankshaft sprocket. Once you've fitted the belt, you can withdraw the pin from the tensioning pulley. After you've withdrawn the pin, you have to rotate the pulley counterclockwise at the hexagon socket until the setting lug is located between the arms of the cutout. Once you've correctly set the timing belt tension via the tensioning pulley, remove the three locking tools again. Then turn the engine over through 10 revolutions in the direction of engine rotation. When fitting the sensor, make sure that the sensor ring and the pulley do not touch, and then refit the timing belt guide on the other side. When fitting the new vibration damper, you need to note the correct fitting position. We have a cutout here and a notch there. The one has to engage the other so that the pulley cannot rotate afterwards. Before fitting the new vibration damper, refit the timing belt guard. To fit the new vibration damper, you use the new bolt from the MS08 fitting kit. Tighten the new bolt to a torque of 30 Nm plus 180 degrees. To do so, the flywheel must be locked at the gearbox with the aid of a pin. Okay, you're almost there. You now just have to complete the engine. Please follow the manufacturer's specifications carefully, especially the torques. Remember, take it gently. Before you let this little babe back on the road, bear our quality stamp in mind. Place our change sticker in a clearly visible location in the engine compartment, so the customer also sees that you've installed quality.